Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences has today decided to award the Sveriges Riksbank Prize in Economic Sciences in memory of Alfred Nobel for 2018, with one half to William D. Nordhaus and the other half to Paul M. Romer.
Two Americans, William Nordhaus of Yale University and Paul Romer of NYU, will split the $1 million prize.
But I'll tell you what I was really surprised about was Paul Romer. Not for the reason you're laughing at.
因为在2016年 Romer 任教的纽约大学曾经乌龙地刊登他是该年的诺贝尔奖得主，还好两年后预言成真了。对于 Nordhaus， 诺贝尔奖于他而言似乎有些来得晚了。金融时报称，诺贝尔经济学奖获奖者平均年龄是67岁， Nordhaus 已经77岁了，就连他的学生早在10年前就获得了诺贝尔奖。这位伯乐发掘了2008年诺贝尔奖得主克鲁曼，当 Nordhaus 的气候赌局出版时，克鲁曼马上在纽约书评上发表了长篇评论，回忆了他当 Nordhaus 助手的快乐时光，并且毫不吝啬地大赞其书。
The Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences said the two men's work addresses some of the most pressing questions of our time.
The winners of this year's Nobel Prize in Economics, Paul Romer and William Nordhaus,have each in their way transformed how we think about economic growth in just these ways. Romer by deepening our understanding of innovation, and Nordhaus by modeling how growth affects the climate and is affected by the climate in turn. Before them, economists basically explained growth as a result of physical investment and capital accumulation. Nordhaus brought the science of climate change into economics. He built the first integrated models of how economic activity and the climate influence one another in complex ways. His work underpins all the estimates of the cost of containing climate change and the much larger cost of doing nothing.
I'm not a big believer in man-made climate change.
这是现任美国总统的看法，新任的诺贝尔经济学奖得主毫不留情地予以回击。
I think one of the problems is there's so much noise now, particularly in this country, about climate change. It's a hoax perpetrated by the Chinese, to help their manufacturing, being one hoax that is particularly, ridiculous.Given that climate change science was invented in the 19th century.
Nobel 经济学奖公布的时机正好是联合国 IPCC 发表气候报告的隔天。该份报告提出最后警告，指出人类化解气候危机的时间仅剩下12年。Nordhaus 提出了他的解决之道。
What can be done to curb climate change? The economist William Nordhaus from Yale University in the United States has been trying to answer this question for over 4 decades. Considered the father of the climate change economy, for Nordhaus, the best solution is to establish a tax of 40 euros per ton of carbon that is emitted.
We are underpricing our natural resources. We are giving away, so to speak, carbon emissions for free. And we need to make sure that people pay the price, that's to say the cost of these damages that this imposes on society in the future.
Nordhaus 教授的理论得到了埃克森美孚石油的支持。曾经强烈质疑地球暖化的埃克森美孚，现在成为第一个拿钱出来对抗气候变迁的石油公司。华尔街日报指出，埃克森美孚承诺未来2年每年拨出$500,000，推动政府对企业开征碳税。
I think it will help. It's always helpful to have bodies such as the Nobel Committee or such as the IPCC remind us about what the stakes are here. And this administration won't last forever. I think it's really anomalous among
in the United States this degree of hostility to environmental policy and climate change policy. So all I can do is hope that we'll get through this without too much damage.